Okay, and you have this problem that you have to know that using deep learning, the main problem is that most of our tutorials on the thing, we have wasted time in installation. Okay, yes, that is the correct word to say, because we have wasted the time in installation, and there are lots of people telling me that why it is not possible to have a very easy deep learning installation or anything. Okay, when you go from Python to C, every installation is not going to be as that as easy. Okay, but there is a claim that people are telling that C is the most fastest one, Python is the most shorter, not that much fast. Even you have Mathematica, Maple and other sorts of computer algebra system, and there is a lots of claim that before 10 to 14 years what they would be saying is those computer algebra system could not handle a bulk data. Okay, like you can't feed them a bulk data and ask for answers. Even MATLAB was one of it, but what happened is MATLAB has transferred from one portion to a very stronger now. Okay, so what has happened is there is no difference that you are going to use a language, this language or that language, because you have a enormous computing power. That is the word I can say to you. So you have enormous computing power. It doesn't depend on your system. Okay, even you go for ray tracing, rendering or anything, the only thing you have to know is you need a graphics card, a good processor and a good RAM. That's it. So you have any kind of software, you could just accelerate. Even for Wolfram you have a CUDA version, right? But even though C++ is the one of the oldest language, when you made to change something in C++ or you install OpenCV in C++, in the BIOS the OS would take its first priority. Okay, everything somewhat talking very advanced, that is not our problem. Okay, let's not talk about it. So everybody has been asking me that can I do a easy object detection, can I make a easy image classifier, can I make other things? Yes, you can do it, but what is the difference is that wasting an enormous time in installation. In our channel about 3000 comments are only about please help me man, I have just configured something wrong. Okay, even I have been using the most famous tutorial in our channel is YOLO object detection in Windows using Cygwin, which is about 26,000 views, but still what people are saying me that I am getting it wrong. So I have given some tutorials down below that video so that you can go and watch and you can rectify everything. But even though there are some sort of trouble keep on coming, so what could go wrong is that not everyone, it is possible that you can do it. Okay, you can install every packages without any error, but it will only take time. But going through the process, you will get very trained in the section of using deep learning, because there are many guys claiming that I am a data scientist, I am that sort of person, that's this sort of person. But the only problem is that even you can't understand your hardware, what is the use of understanding the algorithm or understanding any kind of thing, I don't know. Okay, ask yourself, are you just trained to do it? So what's the problem is that first you have to understand your hardware and its requirement, what is suitable for it. So even you can't do a basic installation, then what is the use of you doing a data science, right? There are lots of people just running slides on YouTube and just explaining all those algorithms and everything. You can understand the theory. Okay, according to our channel, my claim is that we are going to use YOLO for robotics, control system and other things. Okay, control system and other things, we are going to make an expert system oriented concept, but we are going very slow, we are progressing very slow, because we are rectifying all problems day by day. Even when you go and read the comments in our section, you will see lots of people have been benefited by our channel. Okay, it is not nothing to blow my trumpets, but first you have to understand that the main requirement of getting into data science is you have to rectify, you have to be a good bug reporter, bug clarifier, bug killer. Okay, you have to kill your bugs, That is the main thing, okay, when you are getting into this. Even what kind of language you choose is not important. You choose Java, C or Python, the most basic languages, right? But even though you are going to get some problems, you are going to get in somewhere, okay? Even people are asking me that you have lots of problems in Python. But Python is the most easiest way of installing OpenCV and this CUDA and everything. So my claim is that what is Docker? Docker is for persons. You have Android application development. Before 10 years, when you take Android Studio, was not an easy task to install. Even you have lots of tutorials now. Even Linux was not very meant for people who are very for normal users, right? Still people are using Windows, but most of them don't understand that the Windows life ends before this September, okay? The new version is up to 2029, okay? So you will have no support beyond that. But in Ubuntu 18.04, now you are seeing me in Ubuntu 16.04, which has an end life in 2021. Till that you can use. But the Docker command what I am using now is capable of being using in Ubuntu 18.04, Ubuntu 17.10, Ubuntu 17.04 or anything. Okay, let me make a clear claim to you. Okay, whatever tutorial you see on internet is not as easy as you think. You see lots of YOLO object detection tutorial. Even I have made every tutorial about 1 hour. Still people are claiming that the only person who can understand is that the person who is always involved in this. So we have helped lots of PhD students in our tutorial, but still there is a claim that I could not go through your thing because the tutorial is about one hour long, because I have to rectify all errors and reach the end point. Okay, so I could not make a video within 10 minutes span of time. So this is the as fast as I can go, okay, within 1 hour, addressing all the errors and bugs. So almost for YOLO we have cleared almost all errors and bugs, I think so, in Linux, right? Now I don't have a Windows OS, so I could not go there. So first you have to understand that the usage of Docker only depends on people who are very fed up of installation and bugs. Okay, you have lots of error coming in your code, lots of thing coming in your code. You are application developer and still you have errors. And there are lots of claim that people are coming and telling me that please make a Qt app and make a Qt application or any application, whatever you want, you have to bring it to this Docker is not a cloud platform. Okay, you have to understand that it is going to use your resources on the computer what you have, the present hardware. Only is that the image of the OS would be downloaded to your terminal and you will be starting using the terminal in your system. Okay, what is a Linux subsystem on Windows? Linux subsystem on the Windows may be termed into two. One is Cygwin and another is Bash. Cygwin is not that you are bringing Linux to Windows. People are confusing, asking me question again and again, how could you bring Linux into Windows? It is not like that. You have to activate and go into control panel and activate Linux subsystem. What is Cygwin? So Cygwin is just bringing the terminal commands in Linux to the command line in the Windows. Okay, it is not more than that. I could not explain you more than this because I don't have any resource on that. You have to understand that gone through lots of material on the internet, they have and gone through lots of forums. People are telling me that they have been confusing with these things. Okay, Cygwin, I am telling you again, is not at all a Linux in your Windows. It is just the Linux commands in your Windows. It is manipulating the commands in your Windows. Okay, it is just bringing the Linux command. When I was involved in automated theorem proving before 5 years, people in the forum have been talking me, even I had misunderstood the idea of Cygwin. Okay, I have been taken the idea of Cygwin to YouTube because of this automated theorem proving to here. Okay, you have to understand that. Okay, these all are clear. So Docker is for person who are just fed up of bugs, installation and everything. So this tutorial will be on complete configuration. You no need of installing anything. Okay, already I have installed CUDA and everything, but this version of Docker is going to be a very individual one. So please understand what I am doing. So let's get into the tutorial. So Docker, this is the easiest tutorial for deep learning, okay, for every beginner who can start. Okay, why not code? Why are you not explaining the code? I am not explaining the code because the way the world is going is very fast. Okay, I could not stand in any point of the time and being explaining to you the code. Okay, because there are lots of PhD students only asking me on doubt how to run this code. Okay, they are just more superior or more knowledge than me. Okay, they have lots of idea on that. The only trouble is that they claim them as data scientists and they are telling me that they are not able to rectify or kill these bugs. Okay, that was what the problem. So I am telling to rectify all the error because people are telling me that I could not follow your 4 hours to do. You need patience to do that. If you need to succeed, you need patience, hard work and everything. Okay, it was not an easy task for me. I have spent more than 10 nights of configuring all these things. Okay, you have to understand that. Okay, I have not slept for 3 days before doing this. So it is not a very easy task. So this tutorial is for all my lazy programmers out there. Don't discourage your lazy. Sometimes hard work doesn't pay. You have to choose a path which suits you. Okay, laziness is not an issue. Okay, everybody is lazy from top to bottom. It's not an issue. So you have to understand that hard working pays at a point. Okay, still it has not paid me. I have not reached any subscriber or anything, but still working on that issue, but still working for you guys. So you have to understand that using Docker, why do you use Docker? Docker is, again I'm telling you, is for people who are fed up of installation, bug rectification, bug killing, and could not go through all the process. The pre-configured OS will be downloaded to your system and it will be just running on your system using all your resources on your system, not on the server. This AWS, Google Cloud, all are things that you can hire graphics card, CPU or in the cloud. Okay, up to this. Okay, so bug bounty problems, the third one in our channel. So in our channel, bug bounty problems have not been addressed so far because I am not involved in hacking, because I am no more interested in hacking, because I have very limited knowledge in hacking. So even though people are asking me bug bounty problems, you have to understand the basic idea that bug bounty is not an error rectification or a bug rectification. It is a vulnerability identification and it has to be reported to the prompt private sector who is being suffering from any kind of errors or vulnerabilities in their website. Okay, so you cannot go through that. You will not have a resource like GitHub where you have everything served in your dish, everything hot. You can have a delicious dish on GitHub, all the bugs and rectifiers. People would be saying you that thank you, you have solved my problems. But bug bounty is not as easy as that. Okay, because throughout my travel in bug bounty, I have just gone through everything, Kali Linux and everything. You have to understand that bug bounty is not an easy task. Okay, you have to understand that there is no Docker container serving you with all kinds of vulnerability pre-packages or anything. Okay, you have to go through all those things. You have to find the error at the base of assembly code. Okay, it is not an easy issue. We can get this thing to our deep learning. Okay, deep learning is not an vulnerable or an weak subject. Okay, it is just an high subject which has lots of implementation in various fields. Okay, if a hacker could get into your computer, a deep learner can get into your brain. That is the difference. This is all I can say you. So let's see what's Docker, how it could make your application development and everything so easy. Okay, your deep learning and your career so easy. So let's get into the code. Okay, so please don't ask me again about this bug bounty and those stupid programs. Okay, then let's start to install Docker. Before that, we are going to create an email ID, I think so. Okay, then we will start. Okay, before that, starting creating your Docker container, you have to understand that please don't use my container. I'm going to give my some password and use it. Okay, so Docker sign up. Docker, so this is the complete tutorial on how to do Docker. Okay, Docker sign up, where are you? You are here. Okay, right. then give you a Docker ID. Let's see. What is my ID? Okay, you may say that I am in Ubuntu 16.04. You may be claiming that this is not going to work for Ubuntu 18.04. Okay, it will be working for everything. Please don't worry about that. Okay, so Sakthishwaran Docker containers. Okay, Sakthishwaran. Docker containers, give your password. Okay, please don't use my password. You could brute force it and get it. Don't please use it. Okay, I'm just exposing everything because you can understand. That is what I am doing. And please don't make my site or my thing vulnerable. Okay, so what is bridges? This is bridge. Okay, right, continue. Okay, just save it. No, complete your profile, your first name, last name. Thank you for your account created. My name is supposed to be Sakthishwaran. Last name is supposed to be Swan. And company Home Labs, which I am just trying to create. Country is supposed to be India. Okay, India. Right, India. And your role, product manager and technologies. Then what is your Docker experience? I am just familiar with Docker. Okay, right. Quote your email ID, check it. Okay. Right. Okay, here's it. Okay, Docker. Get Google Go. What's this? Oh, something is happening. Google account. Something is supposed to be here now. Nothing is supposed to be here now. Nothing is supposed to be here now. Okay. Where is my email? Okay, email is supposed to be here. I supposed to get my mail in my, okay, something is showing up. Recovered. Okay, no email. Nothing. You will need to verify your email address. That's what I have done. What's it? Okay. So. My verify my email ID. Right. These are all mountains. Already taken. Yes, I know that, no? Username already taken. So, containers. Seminar. For seminar, I'm going to use this. For seminar, it's going to be container. Containers for seminars. I'm going to use it for seminars. In colleges, course. So, value has most 30. Okay, give you a password. Make sure you have given the correct password. This is supposed to be a crisp work. Motorcycle fellow is running in the bike. What is this utmost 30? Okay, you have to reduce utmost 30. It's more than that, I think so. So, Satheeswaran Doctor Seminar would be best, huh? Okay, Satheeswaran Doctor for Seminar. Okay, let's keep it like this. Okay, for Seminar, give your password. Right, I'm not a robot, everybody knows that. Okay. Right, just don't save it. Okay. Or save it. Just save it, huh? India. Okay. The road. Something. Your experience. Running for protection. Still you, okay, you have this talker, please confirm your docker thing. Okay, you have been confirmed your verification is successfully done. Okay, let's see my another inbox. Okay, this is for the email confirmation. This is for Satheeswaran Docker for Signal. So we are going to use this. So now you are going to install Docker. Okay, let me show you that first. You have to understand that Docker you can install for Ubuntu 18.04. Okay, it is available, you can use any one of this, but I'm going to install Ubuntu 16.04, which is also the same procedure for any OS. You have to understand. Okay, the time is running by. Okay, we're going to install Docker Ubuntu 18.04, install it. Okay, get it? Because this would be the easiest tutorial. You can use this Docker container anywhere else. That's up to you. So first what you have to do, you have to get this curl, FFSL, and copy this. Get it to the terminal. Terminal. I think this is the most easy OS, Ubuntu. I love it, but people have been asking me another thing. Sudo apt install curl, I know that. Okay, sudo apt install curl. Okay, let's install curl first, then FSSL. Give you your password so that you can do it. Right, done. The curl, okay, right, it's done. It says okay. Now, Docker repository apt sources. Actually, my net has gone by. What to do? Net is disconnected. Let me make this tutorial after some time. Okay, we are back. That the current is back. So now let's get here. So let's go to install the Docker container. I am telling you again that you install in Ubuntu 18.04, Ubuntu 16.04 or anything. Docker is the same for Windows and everything, okay? You can use this procedure in Windows, Mac or Linux or anything, okay? But only some signs of commands could be changed. So we have installed curl, copy this and go to the terminal, paste it, you say okay. Give you our password. Okay, it is saying okay. Then Docker repository apt resource. This is supposed to stable. For the stable version, you can go. Okay, sometimes 16.04 is a very old one, so you'll have no trouble with that. Okay, Docker run, Docker pull Ubuntu. Okay, not this. Working images. Where am I? Okay, I'm not supposed to be here. Okay, now let's install Docker update. Okay, let's some update, should have to get update. So the next thing would be installing Apache and install Docker. In Ubuntu 18.04 there will be some minor changes. You can check it on the internet. You will get lots of things. Okay, don't worry, don't worry la, be happy. Okay, so sudo apt get install Docker C. Okay, then just install it. Okay, right. Okay, everything is set to be done. Come on, make it fast now. And what you have to do? You have to check the Docker status. There is nothing in this. Okay, I have not installed Darkflow, TensorFlow, anything, but I am going to use Docker to get everything. Okay, right. Check the Docker status. Then let's fire and start now. Okay. Okay, right. Control D. Okay, 1 of 18. 1 of 18. Okay, control D. Just save it out of the. Okay. Okay, right. Go to the terminal. There's no use in nothing if you don't know how to configure your system. Okay, that's all. Docker installation of the Docker is over. You can go and get that site in the internet. There is no problem. Just type install Docker for Ubuntu 18.04, Ubuntu 16.04. If you get some error, come to me. I will help you. Okay, right. Then now what you will do? We are going to log in. Sudo Docker login. Right. Give your password. Okay. Right. Okay. Username. Okay. Okay. Here for seminar. This is my username. Not a big name, huh? But a small password. Don't try to brute force and crack my password, okay? Because I'm not good to get angry because there's no use of doing it, okay? You should see login succeed now. Okay, login has been succeed. Let's clear it. C-L-E-A-R, clear it. So Docker has been logged in successfully. Now what you are going to do is, first we are going to check this yellow.net, right? Not yellow.net, okay. And now what you are going to do, there are lots of things available. So now what we are going to do is, we are going to get three kinds of thing, okay? The first thing would be a container, okay? YOLO dark net docker container, okay, right? Docker container, okay, which is the best? Tell me, which is the best? Tell me. There is no docker pool, okay? Lotterpassi is somewhat good. So docker .net, okay, docker run, docker file, okay, run, like, okay, it's supposed to be GPU. You can do this GPU latest. So we need docker pull for this, okay? This is for Nvidia Jetson. Okay, right, you can do this. You don't need of installing anything. You just buy this Nvidia Jetson from Amazon, okay? Go here, type Jetson, okay, TX2, and you'll be taken to this Amazon. Just buy it, you install Docker, and no need to install anything. It is very costly, 7000, nano is only 10000. You can buy anything. And this has 128 cores of GPU. This has a lot of cores. Okay, you can go and do it. You can use this site for this thing, but we are not going to use this site. So we are going to use this Docker Lotterpassi and Docker Hub for Windows and Linux. Okay, this is the best, I think so. Okay, this thing is the best, I think so. Okay, so you have this. Docker pool, you are supposed to use Docker pool. You have 160 pools of this container, okay? So no need of installation or anything or any rubbish things. You can just run it. Okay, where is it? Okay, right, You need a Docker. Okay, so let's sign in. There's no Docker pool available. Right. So it's just getting into it. Okay, I don't see any pools over here. Docker pool is not available over here. Okay, right. Then what's the deal? There's no Docker pool over here. So you have this GPU and everything based over here, but you have to check it before doing it. Nothing. How to use? Okay. Build it, do it, that. So you have lots of container. Let's check this Docker container, and he has a Detecton container, and he has a FTP face detection data set benchmark. We don't know this, and not this. Okay, right. Docker pull house w docknet. Okay, there is no pull command over here. Okay, where is it? It should be here. It's not showing anything. So the Docker file is this, and still you don't have anything. Okay, right. Okay, let's use this and use Docker pull. Paste and go docker pull and hit enter. Okay, still you don't have this Docker pull, right? Docker pull must be showing here. I don't know why it is not showing. I don't know why, what the problem, my god. Okay, nothing's showing. I don't know the point. Okay, pull, supposed to be pull. Okay, talk a pull command must show. I don't know why it is not showing. Okay, let me check it and show you. Don't waste time, so get here. Sudo sudo paste this command, get docker pull and get this id house bw docknet, and I think this has all sorts of everything in this. You have a lot sorts of graphics card, OpenCV, everything installed in this. As you can see, if you go down, everything details should be given. We'll get into the Docker container and we will check how to upload everything, how to pull a Docker container or do anything. So this container is going to be used for our seminar classes. Okay, so let's first do it. So this tutorial is really long. Okay, let it get downloaded. Let's have a coffee or something and come back. And okay friend, the Docker first container has been done. Okay, if you want, you can check the Docker container by putting sudo docker images. Okay, right. So you have only a single container. It is about 15.9 GB. You have to note that up to how many GB you can occupy the Docker container. Okay, and the next one we are going to get the LOTPRC. Okay, let's go and get this LOTPRC. So okay, Detecton. So this Detecton Docker container, I think, would be the best Docker container. Okay, but we are not going to use it in our projects now. Okay, so it has a mask, arc, CNN, retina net and everything. So we will be using in the later thing, but we will try to pull it. Okay, we will try to pull it. There is about 3k over here. Okay, 3000 people have been pulling it. Okay, so let's pull it now. Let's see how many GB does it cost. So let's see. So it is taking time. Okay, it's a very big file, I think so. So let it get downloaded. Go have a copy and come back. Okay, we are just downloading some of the most important Docker containers. So we have downloaded Detecton. So you have to check whether this Docker images is available. So Docker images for Detecton has been available. Then it has been downloaded. Okay, done. So the next thing would be Docker for Darknet LOTPRC, which has an CUDA enabled one in it. So go and give sudo. Okay, this would be used for our seminar classes in the colleges. Okay, I will tell you what all Docker containers you should download. The people who come to seminar, please use this. Container for this has been downloaded, so we have downloaded the darknet. So I think you need no need of just building it also. Okay, it is not needed. So let's check whether Docker is available in our Docker images. Okay, we have just downloaded it. So I will tell you some of the most important one. So we need some Docker containers for our image classifier. So in order to do for our image classifier, it is, I will tell you the best one for the image classifier is, I will tell you. Okay, go to Google and type MacGyver and 3 minutes image classifier. Okay, this is the one of the most important thing. You can go to his site. Okay, don't make him talk. Get down, get to his blog. Okay, go to the MacGyver code, go to his blog. Okay, and that's it. Close it. Get down. So you are going to use this Docker pull MacGyver thing. It doesn't depend on GPU. Okay, so sudo sudo and paste this, hit enter, let it get downloaded, take rest, we will be back. We are going to use these codes for checking our containers, pulling our containers, and just being using our containers for every purpose we need. Okay, this is the basic. First you have to get the container ID, then you have to get the execute the container, and you have to start using the container. You can use image classifier and everything. So this is the complete tutorial for deep learning. Let's see what. Okay, the TensorFlow thing has been downloaded. The MacGyver, please go and visit his tutorial. He has made a very good container with image classifier algorithms. Okay, you can go, you can also sell your container if you are interested. Okay, right. So these are his container, and the complete tutorial is given. We have also made a tutorial on that. Okay, now what we are going to do is, we are going to search for another container which is so useful for Android production image classifier. So what we are going to do is get into our site. Okay, and go to YOLO object detection windows. YOLO, type YOLO object detection windows, and the first video will be ours, no matter where you're in, where are you in the world. Okay, type Shakti Shuran. Okay, stop this. So our tutorial on this is about, so what I'm telling you about this TensorFlow production for image as classifier app. So this is the one of the most important one. So you have to download this also. Okay, get everything. You can, you go to my site and find this TensorFlow image classifier Android APK using Cordova and PhoneGap thing. Okay, and this is the guy, this is our hero. Okay, he made our tutorial fine. Okay, he has made 84 tutorials. You can also check in the video description what I have given you. Go and check there. Okay, so he has not provided the container, but he has provided the procedure. So this is our container. So you have to copy this and pull the container. Go here and put, instead of using sudo docker pull, you are going to use docker run. Okay, this is going to just pull the docker container. Okay, it is just finding the docker container, it is downloading the docker container, and you will have lots of Android things you can do. You can create a complete image classifier app which detects this Yoda and Darth Vader. Okay, this would be our end of our tutorial. So we have downloaded all the darknet and everything, and moreover there is nothing beyond this. Okay, let's go to the Google and search for some of the famous Docker containers. Okay, famous Docker images. Okay, for deep learning. Okay, for deep learning, and Floyd Hub and Depo. So Floyd Hub, you need to have an account. So Docker images for deep learning AWS is not needed. Okay, Floyd Hub is not, I will be making tutorial on the next. Okay, depot I have not used it till now. Okay, the another thing would be we have a TensorFlow everything. Okay, let's, we don't have a PyTorch, so let's get a PyTorch. Docker PyTorch. Okay, PyTorch container. Okay, container, GPU CUDA container. Okay, we need CUDA also. Okay, let's get this. Okay, Docker enable. We has provided us a thing which is a DPU GPU container. And I will tell you again that I have also made a tutorial on this NVIDIA based Docker container. You can use NVIDIA for every purpose, but for this you have to be very careful on using it. Okay, so what you have to do is you have to get here, go to your, my channel, okay, and you have to search for this NVIDIA digits container. Also I have made tutorial. Okay, you go down and check for these things. I have made a lot of tutorial. I am just willing to make it, I am just making your work very easy. Okay, so I will be discussing here. Okay, this is NVIDIA digits tutorial which I have made. This is also a Docker container which does, normally installing this thing is not very easy. Okay, so please use this code, you can just install, but this had trouble with the graphics drivers. I will make the tutorial on that too. Okay, so this is based on CUDA 10, CUDA 9, 7 and CUDA 8. Okay, this is the Docker image. So let's pull this. Okay, PyTorch enable Docker. So this is going to be the one of the important one. So we need PyTorch. Okay, so let's get here, and this is just getting downloaded. So let it get downloaded. Okay, let me hear to some song or drink a coffee and come back. Okay, the next one would be PyTorch. So another framework we have, YOLO TensorFlow PyTorch. What else we need? Okay, we are ready to rock. So friends, we have some of the most powerful Docker images out there in the market. So first is the MacGyver Docker images for image classification, which could make image classification so easy and so powerful. So next we have this Detectron Facebook oriented Docker container for detecting and RCNN and RCNN and other feeds. Okay, then we have YOLO Darknet with GPU based, and we have this Dan Jarvis thing. So the only thing we need is the image tag is something, but we need CUDA 10 or you need CUDA 8 or anything. Okay, the only thing is that if you need CUDA 10, you have to type CUDA 10. If you need CUDA 9, you have to type CUDA 9. If you need CUDA 8, you have to type CUDA 8. So we are going to pull this container, we are going to install all these things because we are going to use it for our tutorial, right? So then the image tag is that you can use any of these things. Okay, we are going to use PyTorch this thing, but no intimation of any PyTorch is given over here, so we will go with CUDA 10. So we are not have been using this CUDA 9 or anything. Okay, let's use this go SUDO. Okay, so let this be downloaded. I think CUDA 9 is somewhat powerful and CUDA 8 is powerful, so we will get this both things. So some of the most important containers, let's see. Containers you can see 16.04. okay, so let's check some 18.04 or something. okay, these containers will be forever till the world ends, don't worry. Okay, we have just downloaded some of the containers, so let's check this. So we have PyTorch, MacGyver container, Detectron, Darknet, and we are going to use all these containers, and we also have this Android container. Where is it? Okay, it's not over here, okay, it's not anywhere, Low trip parsi, tensor. Okay, Dan Jarvis is the Android container, I'm sorry. Okay, so you have this. So now what you are going to do is you are going to pull this 9th version. Okay, 9.0, okay, and 8 version. So let it get downloaded, and the next one we will be pulling this 8.1. okay, images are also available with 0.4 and 0.3, okay, But the latest version of PyTorch image classifier, you just need this one or anything, okay? If it's needed, we will just do it, okay? There is no problem with that. So let it just download. So you have a very big Docker market out there, okay? And you have another Docker Appium, which is for Android app development, Appium Docker container, okay? Appium Docker container, and this Appium Docker container is specially built for Android app development, okay? And this Appium, you can just pull it. So we are going to pull this also, okay? So you can build anything, okay? You don't need to install ADB or anything. It will start work, okay? Now what you have to do is, you can push the APK file into the container using this command, docker cp users to the opt is the file inside the Docker container, and you can start using it, okay? ADB devices, docker run with privileges, okay? These are all these things. And this is not a compost. Okay, this will be very easy. Don't worry. Oh my God, it's over here. We have been searching for this Docker pull all the time, and it was only down. Okay, so let's get this. Okay, so take a rest. The next thing would be our Docker thing. Okay, so we need one more thing. So let's check it. The PyTorch Docker container has been pulled. So we are going to use this Appium Docker container, which will be later developed for our Android app development. Okay. So let this be pulled, okay? Let's close this. And the next thing would be the most powerful is Android IDE, okay? Arduino IDE, R-D-U-I-N-O, Arduino IDE, Docker pull, okay? Arduino IDE Docker pull, okay? You need a Arduino IDE GitHub-ized Docker pull and CAD IDE Docker pull, okay? CAD, you need to get iZone, which is the best one, just get it. So you have free CAD and everything. If you need some kind of thing, you can go and check it there. And another thing is that iZone free CAD, and you have the CAE Linux Docker pull, okay? CAE Linux Docker pull, which is for the best use for mechanical engineers, okay? You have everything. So what is CAE Linux? You have to know what is CAE Linux. CAE Linux is nothing but it is an environment for simulation, okay? Computerized simulation for flow analysis and everything. So we will be using this all in our tutorial, okay? So just be happy, okay? So the most popular one is CentOS, Red Hat Linux, and everything we are going to just install it now, okay? We are not going to miss any of these things, okay? For server maintenance and everything, if you want, you can just use it. So we need a Puppy Linux thing for bug bounty problems, okay? I told we are not going to use bug bounty, but there is no choice that you need it for a testing purpose, okay? Puppy Linux Docker pull. Okay, with a very little thing, okay? Puppy Linux, P-U-P-P-Y, okay? P-U-P-P-Y, don't leave mistakes, okay? Puppy Linux, Sleepy Puppy Docker, okay, right? Okay, Docker Image Hub, and you need a very, very small thing, okay? You need a very, very small thing, okay? CAE Linux 2013, and we are going to use this 101 downloads, 104 downloads. Okay, this has all the codes inbuilt, so we are going to use the latest one updated before 3 years ago. Okay, we are going to use this. Okay, this is for simulation and everything. Okay, you have everything over here. Okay, this will be using so Sleepy Docker, Nginx, IP address, hope. Okay, so we are not able to get the Puppy Linux for some testing. Okay, you have this Apache. We are not into any server maintenance or everything. That will be in the later part of our tutorial. Okay, So far we don't have anything. So let's check whether we have go.engine with Android inbuilt. Okay, so let's check whether go.engine is available, which is a very powerful thing. Docker pull. Okay, Docker pull. Okay, go.engine, go.android Docker pull. Android Docker pull. Okay, you should have this. So it is somewhat available. Docker with Android should be available over here. So deploy it, you should have these things. Okay, so let's see. In order to run it and do it, you have to have these things. So this is Docker file. In order of using Docker file, Vian, who is Vian? So let's check some of his Docker repositories. So there will be also a tutorial on how to do Docker thing. Okay, so not very talented in this go dot thing, but make sure that you know that there is a thing for go dot also. Okay, right. So exploring, we no need for Apache, or these are all server based ones. Where do we know? Okay, Docker run ESP8266 module. You have to just configure everything for this. We have no time to do that. Okay, these are for embedded. So Docker for embedded would be another part of it. There would be a very big story. So we are going to have this CAD and IZone. Okay, CAD and IZone is nothing but you are going to have these all packages installed. You have first a free CAD and these all things inbuilt to it. Okay, so or else you can go to the CAE Linux and you can just pull it CAE Linux 2013. Okay, or else Docker for Android also. Okay, let's check any powerful images available. Android image. Okay, Docker Android images. So something is over here. So let's see its user thing. Okay, 5 million. Oh my god, people have 5 million people have just downloaded this. So this is a really brick. So what is this? Okay, let's read it. Okay, a part of regular maintenance, changes in images, contents. Okay, something like that. Okay, this is for what, I don't know. Okay, let's check this also. Okay, this is 100k people have this. Restore Docker Android. Okay, this for supposed to be with a YAML thing. You can also build it in any sense. Okay, so you have this, and there is another thing called Docker Android. Okay, Docker Android is something, but Docker Android is a image built, we used related mobile websites, Android projects. Okay, to test Android projects. Okay, you can have this Android versions of anything, and you can just pull it and use it. Okay, so run Docker for Android, and you can just run it. Okay, you have to specify the port value for that. Okay, these are all things. Take a good look at it. You will be doing it in a separate one. You can't be doing this. Is only for deep learning. Our Android container is only for deep learning. Oh my god, I have just done with CAE Linux. So CAE Linux deep learning. Okay, deep learning. Okay, CAE Linux deep learning. You can go to this site and check what is CAE Linux for engineers, for especially for mechanical engineers, for piston design, nothing, all for simulation. Okay, the latest one you can download, but taking to seminar it will have a problem. So what we are going to do, we are going to have a Docker image. Docker pull. Okay, Docker hub. So get down the latest one, 101. Okay, these people are having lots of, you can also use this now, right? Alexi parametric view. So let's check this IZone. So we have just missed with the IZone. Appium has been installed. That's a great news. Before that, what do we need? So we need IZone Docker container. Okay, we will be testing all these things. Okay, IZone Docker container. So for this Hadoop, I don't have any knowledge till now. I may just be doing it later. Okay, what is this? Xmerg. Xmerg is something, but I don't know what is that. Docker file, Docker hub. Okay, I just went to this big data analysis SQL tutorials nearby my house, but no one teach me. But I don't care. So this is the lots of Docker pull. Let's put this thing sudo sudo and make use of this. Right, hit. Okay. Let me stop it and get. Okay, we have just downloaded all the required Docker containers for mechanical simulations and deep learning. Okay, as much as fast we can do. So the one more container we need is for stale transfer. Stale transfer, okay, for stale transfer Docker images. Okay, neural stale transfer Docker images. So these are some stale transfers. We need custom stale transfer. Okay, so these can be used. Okay, so let's make this. So build image locally with, you can also build the image locally down, but we are going to use this installation. Okay, for neural stale transfer. So sudo, this would be the last thing. I will be not worrying you more than this. Okay, and the last thing would be sound classification. Okay, and stale transfer and sound classification. Sound. Okay, we have just downloaded the neural stale transfer. The only thing we are missing is sound classification. Okay, that would be another part of our tutorial. So far we have done it. So the part 2 or in this tutorial, I will teach you how to do image classification within 3 minutes. We have downloaded all the containers we will be doing. Okay, let's rock and roll. So before that, make a good look at this. This is Alberich or something. This guy has given us the Docker neural stale transfer Docker container. So you could make use of this. Okay, just do Docker, make it and run it and make use of it. Put all these things, copy to the container. I'll teach you how. Okay, how to copy to the container and how to do this. Okay, so let's start. Okay, so take a good look at this. Okay, let's start our image classification now. So go to my tutorial. Always I am advising, please go to my tutorial. So let me complete this within 3 minutes. So before that, what you have to do is you have to go here and go to the Google and download some images, download data set. Okay, or get some images for very fast detection. So we are going to use the classic example of detecting dogs and cats. So in order to do, we are going to download all these things. The images will be available over here. So just clone and download it. Okay, just open it. Okay, right, cut it, take it to home. Okay, paste this. Right, now open this, extract it. Okay, right, close it, and where is it? It's over here. Take these images where you have cat and dog 001 002 and copy this. Okay, get back here, paste this. All right, where is it? Is over here. So it is supposed to be renamed as training images. Okay, TRAIN, train images. Okay, and the first one has to be what? It is supposed to be cat images. So rename it as cat, CAT, cat. And the second one is supposed to be what? Dog. Okay, images of dog. Okay, dog, D-O-G, dog. Right, okay, right. Okay, everything has to be done. Now you have to take everything to the container. Okay, C-L-E-A-R. So in order to run the container, you have to get the images of the container. Okay, sudo docker docker images, images, right. So you have this MacGyver container. This is the procedure for no matter what container you are using. You are using CAE Linux, Darknet, TensorFlow for Android, or any app development thing, Appium or anything, PyTorch or anything, you are going to use the same. Okay, I will tell you how. So where is this MacGyver container? yes, we have downloaded. Okay, MacGyver container is over here. So first you have to get the container ID. So in order to get the container ID, you have to go to this site, go to my YouTube channel, get here, okay, and go to this 3 minutes image classifier, okay, 3 minutes IMAG image CLASS. I sorry for the mistake if I have committed, okay, FIER, okay. Oh, something is showing up. Oh my god, something new is showing up. Oh my god. Oh, okay, here's my tutorial, get back there. Some people something may work on someone on work, okay, let's go here. Oh, okay, right. So now what you have to do is you have to get the MacGyver container ID and you have to get started. So in order to get started, you have to go to your GitHub and you have to see whether what all the container is running at the present. So no container is running at the present, make sure that no container is running at the present. So you have to place this and see. Okay, and Dan Jarvis for Android is already running. It has been taken over 31 minutes of running, okay. And now what you have to do is you have to execute this container and start running it. Okay, in order to run it, what you have to do is you have to get this container ID and get here. So sudo sudo, and I think so it is Docker, okay, MacGyver TensorFlow, okay. Okay, it will just fire up some container ID. Okay, this is the container ID. Don't be confused of the other tutorials on the internet may confuse you. Now what you have to do is you have to execute this ID and start running it. So in order to run this ID, what you have to do is you have to use this bash, Docker bash thing. Okay, then you have to get here and put sudo sudo and put Docker and get this IDE, container IDE, and paste this, and sorry for the mistakes, and put bash, BASH, I think so, right? You are in the menu now. Okay, now you have to, what you have to do is you have to check whether this is what, okay, CDLS, okay, right. So this is all the MacGyver's container ID. You have this Jupyter notebook and everything installed in this, right? Now what you have to do is you have to get out of it. Okay, not get out of it. So you can also check this NBCC whether this container has CUDA installed in it, okay. Okay, right, nothing is installed, okay, no problem with that. So now what you have to do is clear everything, CLEAR, clear. So now what we are going to do is we are going to upload some images. So ls, so we are going to just get some training images. In order to get these training images, what you have to do is you have to get this container ID name, and after getting the container ID, you have to close it, and you close this and go to the home menu, and where you have these training images over here, please open the terminal from here. After opening the terminal from here, please paste this command. After pasting this command, hit enter, give your password, okay. Don't forget that you have to give the container ID as prompted given by the sudo darknet, okay. Okay, then now what you have to do is the container will be open over here. After that, what you have to do, you have to upload all the IDE to this container. So in order to upload, what you have to do is you have to use this thing, okay, sudo docker, okay, cp, okay, cp, and get to the end and get here, put slash, and this is the basic command. Copy, what are you going to copy? You are going to copy all this training images, right? Get all these training images, pretending of renaming it, copy it, okay, and just paste it, right, space, hit enter. Okay, it has been copied. Now get into the Docker container. Okay, let's check it, cd slash ls. okay, now the training images should be there. Okay, wonderful, training images is there. If you want to check it, get into the training images and check whether every images is available over there. Okay, don't worry about the internet thing. No matter how slow it is, it will make a copy of it and give ls. Okay, cats and dogs, you have cat and dog folder over there. Okay, just clear it, clear. Now what you are going to do is you have to perform some analysis. Okay, so in order to perform some analysis, you have copied this Docker to that container. So now what you have to do is there has to be training images. So we have made some mistake. So you have to change this to training images, right? Rename it and change this to training images, right? Training images. I'm sorry for the mistake. Okay. Okay. So now let's do it again. Control D. Okay. And what? Copy all these things over there. Okay, so that it will be very fine. Okay, rename it. returning of rename it, copy it, paste it, hit enter, everything will be copied to the thing. Okay, after that it has been copied. Now what they are telling is, let me show you. Okay, now everything has been uploaded to there. So now let's start the container. Okay, now let's execute it. Cd slash, and the slash should be slower over here. Then what you have to do is you have to paste this and hit enter. Now the training should start. Okay, let's see what is happening. Still no trouble. Okay, the training has been started. After the training has been finished, we will be using another thing. Okay, let's see what happens. Okay, the training has started. Okay, this is as easy as that. No installation, no nothing, no anything. Just be happy. Don't gorilla, just be happy. Okay, let's start. Stop this. After the training finish, I'll have go have my coffee and come back. Okay.
Okay friends, today what we are going to do is we are going to test this MacGyver's tutorial on how to make an image classifier in 3 minutes. So let's see how much time it takes for us. It is just a review how to do it. So I'm just doing it. Sudo with Docker. So it is very easy to do, they are saying. So let's see how much time it does it take. So pulling from the TensorFlow status. Okay, it is telling that MacGyver is using default tag. It is already there, I think so. So I have not logged out, I think so. So I have to log out and log in again. Okay, I log in. You have to log in. Okay friends, what is it telling us is that it is already there. So you no need of doing it. So that is what it is telling. So I have already here. Let me show you. Sudo docker psa. So it is already here, my images. So if you put this, the downloading and the SASM, this both thing will come. So it will take a very long time. You have to wait patiently and you have to run it. Then next what you have to do is you have to copy this and you have to put sudo so it will give this id. Then you have to take this container id and execute it to see the kind of images there. So you have to paste this and copy this. I have already some images over there, so I am going to delete it. So you have to put bash sudo. You have to put sudo, I am sorry, sudo. Then you have to put ls cd slash lls and you have all these things over here. And you have this training images over here. So we are going to delete this. So in order to delete that, what I'm, because I have already done an image classification, so I am deleting this. So rm minus r, and what you have to do is you have to copy this and just paste this. And now if you put ls, it will not be there. So it is not there. So now what you are going to do is you are going to get out of this. And now we are going to make a directory called the training images in our folder. And what you have to do is poodles dog and the Kanni dog, Tamil breed dog. So we are going to do this. If you, in order to download all these images, you have to download this extension. This extension will help you batch image downloader. So you have to just copy this and just save this. You have to select the images. You have to select as much as images you like. Okay, and then just save it. All the images to the run. Then you have to take that images from there to you have to take it to the pictures training images, and you have to take to the training images. You have to create a folder called training images, and you have to put Kanni dog and poodle dog. You have to have these two images type. Then now what you have to do is the following thing. So go, just close this Chrome. I have done it in the Chrome. So next what you have to do is you have to copy the training images. In order to copy the training images, you have to do again the following thing. So let me close this, get me here and open the terminal. Then what you have to do is you have to just copy this. So, and you have to copy this thing. You have to get to that folder of training thing. And just copy this. And after that, what you have to do is, you have to go to this, you have to create a training, that all I have told you. Then you have to copy this to the Docker container. So in order to do that, you have to just copy this and space bar, and let me tell you, and home sudo, and you have to put a bar slash over here and give end. If there is no error, it will come without error. Then you have to create a folder called test, and in that test you have to copy some of the images in order to test in here itself. And what you have to do is you have to just copy that images to the Docker container. So let's do it. So this is the most easy tutorial for this thing. So now let's check whether the containers have these things. So let's check whether the containers have these things. So let's copy this and then paste this. Let's delete this and put the new container ID, because it will give you a new container ID each time you open it. Now cd ls, it's not there, sorry, cd slash ls, and now you have new set of training images. So you have to go to the inside the training images and you have to do it. Now cd, no need of cd, so just get out of this. And now what you have to do is you have to start the training. In order to start the training, what you have to do is you have to copy this and you have to just paste this, copy this, and again you have to type sudo docker exet, and you have to just paste this. This is the most easiest tutorial. No such. Okay, now what you have to do is cd slash ls, and you have to have all these retrained folders and everything. And now what will happen is the training will start, and let's not disturb it. So let it take its own time. the training has started. So you see, I have not installed the TensorFlow or anything in my system, but I am still using how to train it. This will be a very good one for everyone to just start up. So please follow this. So the training has started. It will stop itself, then we will start our thing. Okay, thank you. And we are going to test everything. Wait for it. So dear friends, the test is over. So let's check this. LS. And in here where we are going to test the images. Let's see where is the test folder. It is over here. So CD test LS, and you have all these images. And now what you have to do is you have to go here and you have to copy this. This will take some time, but it will be okay. Just paste this. So you have to go to the test and copy this image and see whether what is this. It cannot open the file. No such file. Label image dot file. Retrain label image dot file. Okay. Python TensorFlow, TensorFlow examples. TensorFlow, Python, TensorFlow, TensorFlow examples, and here are this thing. I don't know how did he do it. Let's see. It's over. TensorFlow, TensorFlow images. Images, German Shepherd. German Shepherd. Have it on test images. Damnation to images. And you have to have this image. Major byte. Okay, we have to get into the other folder. CD. CD slash LS, and you have to copy this. You have to get into the same folder, I think so. Not Obama test. And now what you have to do is you have to get into this and just. So you have it, you have the training images detecting this thing. So you have to be in the outer side of the folder to get, in order to get this. So you have this, not Damnation Bulldog, it is supposed to be Cunny Dog. So Cunny Dog is about 0.00169, or it is a Poodle Dog. You can see that it is a Poodle Dog. So let's see what is this images in the real time. So let's see what is this image in the test thing, I think so, in test. So let's see what's this image. So that's a poodle one. So it has detected it correctly. So we have just made an image classifier within seconds. So this is the tutorial, and thank you friends. Please like, share and subscribe.